In this video, we will discuss shell shot. So this shell shot actually derives from insertion shot. So if only some of the elements are not shorted, then in insertion shot it requires only few swaps. Okay. Let's take this example here. Let us try to perform insertion shot. So here 3 is already shorted, then 5, 3 and 5 already shorted. Try to insert 8 into this side, it is also already shorted. 16 is already shorted, up to this the list is shorted. Now 13, now if you want to insert 13 this side, 16 needs to shift this side and 13 comes here. Okay, so the list 3, 5, 8, 13, 16, now 11 and 18. So up to this list is shorted. Now try to insert 11 this side. So to insert 11 this side, 16 needs to be shifted, 13 needs to be shifted. Okay, so 3, 5, 8, then we compare 11 and 8. As 8 is smaller, 11 is inserted here, then 13 was shifted, 16 was shifted and then 18. So up to this list is shorted and now try to insert 18. So as 18 is greater than 16, it is already shorted. So as we have seen ki before this number of elements, 7 elements, only few swaps are required because list was almost shorted, only few of the elements were not shorted. Okay, so this is the idea behind shell shot, where we will perform insertion shot only but with gap. Okay, so let's take one more example where the elements are 9, 5, 16, 8, 13, 6, 12, 10, 4, 2 and 3. So there are total 11 elements in this array. Okay, I want to short them using shell shot. Okay, so here gap. Let us calculate gap. How would you calculate gap? Gap is nothing but total number of elements, 11 divided by 2, and floor function I'll apply. So now gap is equal to 5. So now we will perform insertion shot itself but with the gap of 5. So my first element is 9, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So now I'll perform insertion shot on these two elements only, okay, with the gap of 5. So I'll perform insertion shot on 9 and 6 only, other elements remains as it is. Okay, so as 6 is smaller than 9, 9 needs to be shifted. Okay, so 9 comes here. And 6 comes here. Now we'll shift the pointers. Okay, so this pointer comes here on 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 10. Now we'll perform insertion shot on a 5 and 12. So 5 is smaller than 12, so we have performed insertion shot and no need to do any swapping. Okay, next again shift the pointer. Okay, so now my pointer is on 16 and 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 16 and 10. As 10 is smaller than 16, 10 comes here and 16 comes here. Okay, now again let us shift the pointer on 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4. 8 and 4. So here 4 is lesser, so 4 comes here and 8 comes here. Now again shift the pointer. So now pointer is this side on 13 and let me assign the indices also. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 and 10. Okay, 0 to 10, total 11 elements. So now my pointer is on 13, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 and 2. Now you have to check this side also. If there is a gap of 5, you have to consider that element also. So let me check 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. It goes out of the array, so still no need to bother about it. So let us compare 13 and 2 only. Okay, as 2 is smaller, 2 comes here. Okay, and 13 comes here. Now again shift the pointer. My pointer is on 9, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 on a last pointer, and this side also 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So now let us perform insertion sort on this 3 element with the gap of 5. So 6, 9 and 3. 6 already shorted, 9. 6 and 9, 9 is greater than 6, so already shorted. Now compare 6, 9 and 3. 3, compare 3 with the 9. As 9 is greater, 9 needs to be shifted. So 9 comes here, 3 comes here. Again 3 is compared with 6. As 3 is smaller, 3 comes here and 6 comes here, and other elements remains as it is. Okay, so this is the output of first pass of shell short with the gap of 5.